peace is flowing, so that we still got to remember and pray for them and pray for an end to the hostilities and the wars taking place there. So 7:31, if you got your missal up with you.
Peace is flowing like a river.
Reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once to your people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt, for they have become depraved. They have soon turned aside from the way I pointed out to them, making for themselves a molten calf and worshiping it, sacrificing to it, and crying out, 'This is your God, O Israel, who brought you out of the land of Egypt.'" The Lord said to Moses, "I see how stiff-necked this people is. Let me alone then, that my wrath may blaze up against them to consume them. Then I will make of you a great nation." But Moses implored the Lord, his God, saying, "Why, O Lord, should your wrath blaze up against your own people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt with such great power and with a so strong a hand? Why should the Egyptians say, 'With evil intent he brought them out, that he might kill them in the mountains and exterminate them from the face of the earth'? Let your blazing wrath die out. Relent in punishing your people. Remember your servants, Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, and how you swore to them by your own self, saying, 'I will make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and all this land that I promised, I will give your descendants as their perpetual heritage.' So the Lord relented in the punishment he had threatened to inflict on his people." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Remember us, O Lord, as you favor your people.
Remember us, O Lord, as you favor your people.
fathers made of Kiath in Harim and adored a molten image. They exchanged their glory for the image of a grass-eating bullock.
Remember us, O Lord, that you made your people.
They forgot the God who had saved them, who had done great deeds in Egypt, wondrous deeds in the land of Ham, terrible things at the Red Sea.
Remember us, O Lord, that you made your people.
Then he spoke of exterminating them, but Moses, his chosen one, withstood him in the breach to turn back his destructive wrath.
Remember us, O Lord, that you made your people.
Alleluia, glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him might have eternal life. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jews, "If I testify on my own behalf, my testimony is not true. But there is another who testifies on my behalf, and I know that the testimony he gives on my behalf is true. You sent emissaries to John, and he testified to the truth. I do not accept human testimony, but I say this so that you might be saved. He was a burning and shining lamp, and for a while you were content to rejoice in his life. But I have testimony greater than John's, and the works that the Father gave me to accomplish, those works that I perform, testify on my behalf that the Father has sent me. Moreover, the Father who has sent me has testified on my behalf. But you have never heard his voice nor seen his form, and you do not have his word remaining in you, because you do not believe in the one whom he has sent. You search the scriptures, because you think you have eternal life through him. Even they testify on my behalf, but you do not want to come to me to have life. I do not accept human praise. Moreover, I know that you do not have the love of God in you. I came in the name of the Father, but you did not accept me. Yet if another comes in his own name, you will accept him. How can you believe when you accept praise from one another and do not seek the praise that comes only from God? Do you not think I will accuse you before the Father? The one who will curse you is Moses, in whom you have placed your hope. For if you had believed Moses, you would have believed because he wrote about me. But if you do not believe his writings, how will you believe my words?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have Moses, the first reading, and we have Moses, how he gone up the mountain, received the Ten Commandments, remained up there for a while, and the people just kind of lost their way very quickly. And when he came down, he said, they were worshiping a golden calf. And the Lord said to Moses, this is a stiff-necked people, and let me blaze my wrath upon them. And Moses kind of was, he kind of had an appeal to God on the waywardness of his people. And the Lord then did relent in his punishment that he had threatened to inflict on his people. So we have that image of the golden calf. And maybe sometimes we have a golden calf in our lives. What do I mean by that? We don't have a real golden calf, but maybe we have something in our lives that proves distractful or takes us away from God or takes us away from what we should be doing. And we know what we should be doing versus what this golden calf is having us do, so that we have Jesus speaking about that golden calf that people were worshiping, and that we have to recognize our own failings at times, and maybe our failure to make Jesus at times a priority in our lives, so that we do recognize our failings, we seek out the sacrament of reconciliation, and we approach the Lord with contrition. Jesus is our intercessor, and he's ready to stand before the Father as an advocate for us. And knowing that his words lead to eternal life, we now lift our prayers and petitions to our loving Father. For church leaders, may the Lord bless their efforts to guide their flocks in the saving work. Let us pray to the Lord. For the people and nations of the world, especially for the people of Ukraine, may the peace of Christ reign in their lands and hearts. Let us pray to the Lord. For the victims of violence and abuse, may the power of God's healing love bring them to safety and peace. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who are preparing to enter the church this Easter, may God in the prayers of this community strengthen them on their journey. Let us pray to the Lord. For all the faithful departed, may God's love and mercy support them and bring them to everlasting life. Let us pray to the Lord. And for all religious living and deceased, let us pray to the Lord. Father, we trust in your kindness and compassion. Hear our prayers, we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness. We have this bread to offer, which with his good human hands are made, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be our forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for your
Grant me prayer, Lord God, that what we offer as sacrifice may cleanse us in our frailty from every evil, and always grant us your protection through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and Christ our Lord. For by your gracious gift each year, your faithful way, the sacred Paschal feast, give the joy of minds made pure, so that more eagerly intent on prayer and the works of charity and participating the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they may be led to the fullness of grace that you bestow on your sons and daughters. And so with the angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, have mercy. Have mercy, Lord, your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are seen, O Lord, the Fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. How may we pray that, partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread about the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, place our bishop, his auxiliary bishops, and all the clergy, and all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, as Joseph, your spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Catherine of Alexandria, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him. O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. And now, let us pray for the coming of the kingdom in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. And by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory of your Son, and of God, and of God.
The Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, live not in our sins, but out of faith in your truth, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. The Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. The Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Thank you.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. And a reminder that Monday through Friday, we have our Adoration Chapel open from 3:15 to 6:15. And anybody who's been to the chapel yesterday, let me know if there was any leaks still. We had the roofer out to look at it, and we did some patching. So let me know, because a lot of rain came down yesterday. I know we got some water in the basement of the rectory. But, so let me know if there was any leaks in the Adoration Chapel. Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received purify us, we pray, O Lord, and grant that your servants freedom from all blame, that those bound by a guilty conscience may glory in the fullness of heavenly remedy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you. Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. And I will sing number 731, Peace is Flowing, verse 3. Faith.